In the 1940s, it was an exciting time for a young writer in Australia. As a boy whose father worked in news, he learned how certain headlines tended to sell better. And people loved buying headlines related to sports, to scandals, and celebrity relationships. Headlines that interrupted patterns, left the reader curious, and told people what they wanted to hear, even if it wasn't the truth, tended to fly off the shelves. So when his father gave him control of his Adelaide newspaper in the 1950s, he turned these editorial best practices into the way that they did business. This method of basically tabloid headlines turned out to be very successful. Newspapers were flying off the shelves. And by the 1960s, this local newspaper was looking to buy news companies throughout Australia and around the world. In fact, by the 1970s, he became a U.S. citizen so that he could own U.S. television stations, which grew into television networks like Fox in the 1980s. And sports programs like the NFL in the 1990s. The broad reach of his newspapers meant that he held great power over political elections in Australia, the UK, and the United States. His support was credited with victories leading up to the elections of US presidents such as Ronald Reagan, Barack Obama, and Donald Trump. This influence also had a direct impact on news regulations, such as those prohibiting one person from owning both a television station and a newspaper in the same market. So you can imagine, hey, we let you win the election. Why don't you just relax some of those regulations that we have on news? That's exactly what happened. Now, by now, you probably already guessed that I'm talking about media magnate Rupert Murdoch, who has been credited with inventing the modern tabloid by The Economist. You may be wondering, what does this have to do with AI and what we see in our news feeds? Very interesting question. So, these exact same principles were applied to the internet in the 2000s when Murdoch's News Corp acquired the internet social media platform MySpace and later IGN, or the International Gaming News Organization. Many media companies, including Group 9 that owns Thrillist, Now This, Seeker, they all apply the same modern tabloid style headlines that worked so well in the 1950s. I mean, if it worked back then, why do I need to change it? You keep doing what works. So if you're curious about why your newsfeed has articles related to scandals or curiosity-driven headlines that keep you hooked for hours on end, you have the modern tabloid to thank.